Spike flex on the lookout. Fire you up like a cookout. Boy, you're trash, you get took out. Study my swag, get a book out. Piccolo, you have no sauce. Hey, I can see you like a boss. Hey, your girl look like Rick Ross.
Yes, she does.
Hey, me and Popo take no loss. Hey.
What's going on YouTube? As you guys can see, we're more than halfway there to our yearly goal. Our yearly goal is to get partnered by YouTube by the end of this year, so it would be very much appreciated if you guys could leave a like on the video and also subscribe to the channel. I'm out. Peace. Enjoy the video. Yay!
What's going on? It's your boy BulletHound. I'm bringing you guys another ESO video. Don't forget to leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if you have not, and also hit that bell notification to be notified for every time I'm live streaming videos. We very much appreciate it. Actually, right after this, I'm about to live stream too, so yeah, stay tuned for that. But anyways, let's get straight into the video. First things first, I'd like to welcome all the new viewers to my channel. And if you guys know nothing about my channel, this is your first time or whatever, basically my channel is beginner friendly and I only talk about beginner stuff. And the reason I emphasize that is because there's veteran players who always come inside the comment section again and say that, I know about this already. It's like, I know you know about this, but there's a lot of new players to this game that don't have any idea how this game operates, the mechanics about this game, and you know, how this game just like functions. Stuff like that. So now let's get straight into the video. So as you can tell from the title of this video is basically how to make your own build, or how to make your own character, whatever you want to call it, whatever's good for you. But yeah, so this is basically how to make your own build, and yeah, I'm going to be showing you guys like the beginning step number one and step to like, well, this is the steps that I take, you know. But yeah, I'm going to show you guys like step by step how to make your build. And not trying to go, you know, too in depth about it, like the DPS and stuff. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to show you guys like the template of making your build, if that makes sense. But yeah, so let's get straight into it right now. So first things first, before making your build, you need to know what type of character you want. Well, not what type of character. If you want your character to be magical based or stamina based. Like my character right now, he's magical based. So what do you want your character to be? Magicka or stamina. Every class has a stam or magicka, like abilities and so forth. Some excel, some are better than the other. Some, you know, it's not really like, oh, the other side stam sucks or whatever. Just like for a necromancer, I believe the highest DPS class is a stam necro. Correct me if I'm wrong, or it's a stam warden. I'm not sure, but that doesn't mean that magicka necros are like. That doesn't mean that at all. It just means that they have the potential to put out the most DPS. But that doesn't mean, oh, pick this class because it has the most it has the potential to put out the most DPS. Keep in mind, you have to be, first of all, you have to have gear, and second, you have to have the skill to put out that much DPS. So don't go online and say, what is the highest class for damage? Every class does a lot of damage. Every class you know, does a good amount of damage. So just because the reviews say, oh, this class does the most damage, doesn't mean that you're gonna do that much damage, because you're probably not used to a necro, or you're not used to a templar. Well, templars are really easy used to, but you're not used to a nightblade and stuff like that. So you check up, oh, nightblade whatever, and then you try to use the same setup and same build whatever, and you end up doing basically way less DPS than what you would do with a different class. That's because that's just not your playing style. Now you could just go far beyond this game and, you know, I'm just a stud at this game and, you know, master every single class. But that's like, you know, rare. Some people just like to do Templars. Some people just have Nightblades just for crafting, just like me. I like Nightblades, don't get me wrong, but I don't know. I just wanted to try something else because I've been playing Nightblade for a long time. So. But anyways, yeah, so that's what you need to figure out, and hopefully you guys are understanding what I'm saying. If I'm talking this fast, just let me know. If I'm like not explaining things well, just let me know. So figure out stam or you want magicka. Magicka seems to be more easier on console because of the frame rate, but they do have the new Xbox X's now on PS5, so I haven't tried it out. I'm not sure. Let me know inside the comment section if PS5 and the Xbox X, the Xbox Series X actually put out like more frames, stuff like that. Let me know if the performance is well. That's why it's like me, I kind of hate playing the stamina class on Xbox, on console period, because The frames are just really, really bad, and you have to change into like a certain costume. So it's just bad for me. But for other people, I guess they like it. It's like fun to them. But for me, the frames are bad. The light attacks hardly go off and stuff like that. Abilities hardly go off and stuff like that. When you're Magicka, you could get away with a lot of stuff. You know? But that's just my experience and my personal preference and my style point. But you guys, I'm most likely good at both. But yeah, so just make sure that you find out where, if you want to be a Stam or you want to be a Magicka. The second thing that you need to do is research gear. Now I'm gonna switch over to my PC right now. So as you guys can see, I'm researching right now. Basically, I typed in ESO Magicka craftable sets. You don't have to type in craftable sets. You could just type in monster sets, dungeon sets, overland sets. Yeah, so this would be the ESO wiki, whatever it's called. You could go to the overland gear and this is probably like the easiest gear to get. You could either buy it or you could grind for it. And it may take a few times to like grind for it and stuff like that, like Devourer. Ryheart is really, really good. I haven't tried like the rest of them. That I know that for the one that you can just read this, that Mother Sorrows is good. This is like my, let's see what I write about. Yeah, and River Spring. And you could check where they drop out and stuff like that. For Deshaun. So play Doctor, drop a Deshaun too, and you can see the Dells drop the weights and pro box, they drop the heads, chest, somewhere. And so on. So whatever gear you want, look at the stats. What do you want your build to be and stuff like that? What is it? Yeah, so this is probably the new DLC. Yeah. It adds 1,400 physical damage, physical penetration. Whenever you kill an enemy afflicted with a poison effect, their corpse would have petrifies without the enemy within 12 meters, causing them to bleed for 31,000 physical damage. Over. God damn! Hold up. That's a lot. Especially when you put champion points. My bad. I never saw that. That's why I was like, what is it? But yeah, I think there's like other ones. Some of them are like weak. But keep in mind, you guys, that that is the new collection thing where you could get rid of like gear and stuff like that. But before you could like before people would do would just fill their bank up with like even this or whatnot, well probably not. But like they will keep certain gear because new updates will buff up the gear and stuff like that, such as like Medusa, nobody used that set at all, but now adds like a lot of crit, so you want to use like Barb Trap. It adds minor force to it, so you don't have to use Barb Trap anymore, or you don't have to use what's that fish? Accelerate Morph. I'm not sure what it's called. I've played this game in a while, I'm not gonna lie. That's why people kept like certain gear, but you could definitely grind for like other gear, store it just in case it gets buffed and stuff like that. But there's nothing wrong with that. So if you want to do like a, let's say if you want to do like a plane damage build, I mean, not a plane damage, but a bomb build. So you look into the explosive. So it says when you successfully, and this does spell and weapon damage, but it's mainly, as you can see, it's mainly for like stamina. But it says when you successfully bought a bomb on an enemy for 10 seconds, when they are hit with a fully charged attack, a bomb detonates, dealing 13,000 flame damage to all enemies within 8. This can occur every 8 seconds. So you guys can see this is good for like probably PvP. Not really good for PPE, All you gotta do is just read the stats and see if it's good for PvE or PvP. Such as like dot builds and stuff like that, that's probably good for PvP. I say PvP, but I mean, if you're running like, you want to run like a dot build in PvP, and too, just don't just take my word for it. Don't take anyone else's word for it. Again, try to make your own builds and stuff like that, because that's how you make this game fun, instead of copying someone else's build and stuff like that. Because you guys gotta keep in mind that this game is based upon your personal preference. It is not really based upon, oh, this is the ultimate set, this is the meta or whatever. Yeah, there's, as you guys can see, it's all, this is just the overland gear. Like, let's go to like the crafting sets and stuff. So we go to like the crafting sets, which is the crafting sets and the overland sets are the easiest ones. Dungeon sets are probably a little bit harder to get, depending on what you're trying to get. Like Fangler, their dungeon sets are pretty hard to get and stuff. But yeah, the crafting sets are pretty easy to get too. Some of them require two traits, but the harder ones like New Moon's Accolade and the other ones. Hold on. Which one's the new? Let's see if we can find them. Let's see. Is Mark Martin? That's not the new DLC. It's similar. It starts with an M, but I know that's not the new. I don't think it is. If it is, my bad. But check out the DLC. There we go. Yeah, it's not. So this one right here. I might look into this one. This crazy. So this one right here. It says adds weapon. So this, you could basically this right here, you could either put it on a Masco or stamina. It doesn't matter because it has weapon and it has spell. So it says add 469 weapon spell power to your weapon skill abilities. Increase the cost of your abilities by 5%. So there's some abilities. This is probably really good though. Like that's a huge, that's like a huge amount of damage. So that's why this is like another New Moon Accolade and stuff. This one right here, it says adds 7,000 increase block cost, sprint, victory. Damn. So you have to see there's some abilities that have like a, but you could probably even this out with that sustain ring. I forgot what that's called, but yeah, you could easily like put like a, probably like a mythic item, well, that sustained mythic item, and even it out or something like that. You know, just think about, okay, if this has a penalty to it, so you have to focus resources. So probably a Breton will be good for this, because it doesn't cost you that much resources. Unless you're advanced, then you could, you know, fuck with the high elf, it doesn't matter. But you know, there's a lot of other abilities, Numa Aquay, you know, this is like a little old set. I think this took over the Moon Accolade, whatever. I showed you guys the research and stuff like that. Think about what type of build you want to make, a hybrid build. You want to make, and I know people say, well, hybrid builds are like old, blah, 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 blah. But if you want to make it, just make it. Don't try to depend. Don't try to listen to other people. You know what I'm saying? Listen to other people to get their input and information, but don't like just take it as like a Bible and just, oh my gosh, this is like the Holy Quran. I'm just going to just freaking just do exactly what this person say. You know, a lot of people's builds are based upon other people's builds, and based upon other people's builds and so forth. So it's like a chain goddamn reaction, and people just listen to other people instead of listening to themselves. So listen to yourself, do your own research, become more knowledgeable about the game, because when you're done making your magic, you're gonna have lots of fun. And keep in mind that I can't believe I have to say this. But just because you are a stan or character does not mean that you only use magicka or stan ability. That's insane. The reason why I'm saying that is a guy came in and basically, oh, if you're a stan character, I could tell that you don't know how to play the game because you don't know you're using a magicka abilities on a stamp character, on a stamp store. I'm like, you're a fucking retard. If you really believe that you can't, let me check this out. So look, the reason why I was using that ability is because, look, it says an ally near the, which is this the ultimate here, it says basically by ally, they gain major berserk by 10% for 8 seconds. So whoever said that, I'm not sure who that was. I'm not trying to bring it up. It's old, it's done with. You are a retard, sir. You are retarded. Don't ever play ESO. He claims to be a level 900. So you have to correct people sometimes, because that was just so stupid what that guy said. I had to respond to that. But yeah, so as you guys can see, just look up the abilities, look at the passes. So if, all right, let's say, okay, it reduces your ultimate cost, and this right here restores blah blah blah. Sometimes you don't need that extra sustain because your build is just, it already has enough sustain. So focus on DPS. Like Templars, they have a lot of sustain, so you may not need that much a set that has that much sustain. So just focus on DPS sets or sets that just give you increase your crit and stuff like that. Keep in mind that you can use light armor, you can use heavy armor. If you choose to use heavy armor on a like a Magicka character, make sure you have, like, let's say Medusa. Medusa's a set that requires heavy. Now, I made a build where I have the lightning staff or Inferno, I'm not sure, the Inferno staff or lightning staff of the Medusa. So basically, the reason why I wouldn't recommend getting the staff is because this takes up two slots. I mean, not two slots, sorry about that. But this, so basically, if I let go of this, right? There you go. So if I let go of this, this basically takes away my two bonuses I get from this this set, and I add it, then I gain two back. Now that works with basically, this is actually it, right? It's two right here, so I gain a bonus from it. But if I take it away, I don't get it. So when people talk about front bar sets and back bar sets, what you want to do is front bar Medusa. One is that piece, is this right here, is that gain binding force at all times, increasing your crit damage by 10%. You want that. So what you do instead of getting the Inferno staff, you do is get a chest piece, a heavy chest piece, and make everything else light. So normally people rock 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and leave the head and shoulders alone. That's for like monster sets. And they'll rock another 5 piece, 1, 2, 3. They'll rock 1, 2, 3, and basically 4 or 5, because the 200 weapons takes up 2 slots, because obviously and dual wielded that is 200 weapons. So takes on two bonuses. If you slot a one-handed ability, I mean a one-handed one, it'll only take up one, but slot two, and it'll take up two. Simple. That makes sense, right? So what people normally run, they'll run that. So they'll run 2 5-piece sets. Sometimes they'll run 2 5-piece set, no monster set. Just actually read through everything. You could use, you know, make sure from the time you become level 1 and time you become level 50, you know what your build is going to be. Make sure you work on your skills, you leveling up your skills and stuff like that. And yeah, so those are all the tips I could give you. Just to see, I didn't tell you what set to run and shit like that. I'm just telling you how to build your set and what's the best ways and stuff like that, and how people do it. Do your own research. You're gonna have much more fun creating your own build. It may take one or and it may take a whole day, it may take a year, it may take months or whatever, but the reason why it takes that long is because you're trying to perfect everything. You figure out, okay, this my weakness are night blades because I can't see them, so you add some type of potion to the cloak them, but then you lose certain crits and stuff like that, so you got to add extra crit, you gotta add weapon damage and stuff like that, make your gliss, ask people to make your gliss so you're not a master crafter and stuff like that. So it takes a lot of time, takes a lot of resources. This is why, you know, when people make builds, I have much respect for them because it takes a lot of time and research and also money to fucking make, to actually make a build, you know what I'm saying? So it is what it is. You guys can do whatever you want. It is what it is because there's a lot of million, and again, there's a million different sets in this game, not literally a million. There's a lot of different sets in this game. Just be you, do you, and be yourself. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully it was information.